Now, the topic for the fireside chat is the connecting Latin America to Asia, an entrepreneur's view. So we'll be hearing more from the private sector, and this is going to be on another equally engaging talk. Now, may I invite the two speakers from the fireside chat onto the stage, please? That's great. Let me introduce, please, you can be seated, and I'll be introducing to you. So we have the two speakers for the fireside chat. Let me briefly introduce to you who they are. Well, first, we have Mr. Matthias Bendersky, Chief of Resource Mobilization Division at IDB. Let's welcome Mr. Bendersky with a big round of applause first. Thank you. And next to him is Mr. Moishe Mana, Chairman of Mana Group from the United States. Let's welcome him too with a big hand. So please, go ahead.
Well, hello, everybody. Thank you for being here with us today. I'm very pleased to be joined by Mr. Moishe Mana, a very visionary entrepreneur, thank you, who can share with us a very unique perspective on efforts to connect Asia and Latin America and the Caribbean. On Crunchbase, Moishe is defined as the personification of the American dream. Born and raised in Tel Aviv, he arrived in New York City with hardly any money to his name, working hard in the restaurant business and later in construction. He began a moving company that quickly became one of the largest Northeast logistics company. He saw an opportunity in the storage business. He created a real estate empire after that. Now Mr. Mana is transforming Miami into a hub where entrepreneurship meets the creative class, and now it's building, as he claims, the new Silicon Valley for Latin America and the Caribbean, providing a bridge for Korean and Asian investors to the land of opportunity, Latin America and the Caribbean. So, Moishe, we have 20 minutes, and you have a lot to say. Tell us a little bit about the ecosystem you're building in Miami.
Okay, hello everybody. I'm glad to be in Korea and...
Hello,
yes. So I'm glad to be in Korea, and I've been coming to Korea here over the last few years. So here we go, I'm here. What we are doing really, it's taking all my experiences in businesses and combining it into a philosophy. I've done different businesses, you know, from logistics to technology to fashion to art, real estate, everything was vertical, everything a standalone business. But I got to realization that we need to do better and to try to combine all my experiences into creating one combined business, if I can call it, which is coming to, we call it an ecosystem. And I ended up going to cities, it's part the vision of Miami, the Silicon Valley. It's part of a bigger vision where we go into cities and we buy critical mass of real estate in unwanted areas, and we create a community. We invest in the community. We don't look at ourselves as just like landlord. We partners with the businesses coming into the community. We provide art services, fashion services, technology, trades, whatever it takes, we provide the people the opportunity to use this infrastructure. It became an infrastructure. We started the meatpacking. I was the first one to do the meatpacking, then in Jersey City, the largest art center in America, and then I went to Miami. Miami represented a different set of problems, and it's like onion that you're peeling. You know, I didn't know where I was going, you know, but I knew I was going to build an ecosystem when we needed the cultural hub of Miami to be built in somewhere, which was Wynwood, I was with the early investors of Wynwood. Today, it's one of the most popular areas in America, and it became a big ecosystem where servicing the cultural hub of Miami. So, but from there, I start really looking further what Miami could do and how our business can service Miami. And very fast, I found that we have next to us a continent called Latin America. And I said, okay, so basically what we do, we're going to provide our real estate, what we're doing, everything. We build the ecosystem to connect Latin America to the rest of the world. Latin America, as you know, is very fragmented. And it's built from small countries that each one stand by itself. So Latin America, it's the world need to connect to Latin America. It's very difficult, 33 countries or 34 countries, all separated. And at the same time, Latin America having hard time connecting to the world. The world has not realized yet what is really the opportunities that Latin America representing. But it's also, for me, I took it as a social impact project because I saw the opportunity. And what we did, we came with a couple of projects. The Silicon Valley that you're talking about, I went to downtown Miami, abandoned area. It used to be the center of Miami, the heart of Miami in the past. Because every owner was 80 years old, 90 years old, nobody wanted to change anything. I said, okay, we're going to buy everything what we can buy. We bought 60 buildings. And I had a vision what we could do with these 60 buildings. I figured that Latin America need a place where all the countries, all the entrepreneurs from everywhere will connect to one place, one ecosystem. So it's going to be much easier for the world to connect to this, to all the countries. Because for the world to go from one country to the next, it's complicated. It's not easy. So if we build Argentina next to Peru, Peru next to Colombia, this creates bigger opportunities for Latin America and for the world to connect to Latin America. Because we're still living in a physical body, and the connecting to physical, when you go into a place, to workplace, when you're next to you working other countries. So we can create an application like WhatsApp. China created WeChat. Latin America doesn't have it because every country works by itself. America has Uber. China has Didi. Latin America doesn't have it because it's all very fragmented. So I figured building this ecosystem and supporting the ecosystem through direct investment. And we do invest in technology. We have over 72 companies that we invested with, and investing in the fashion services, art services, and create neighborhood that's going to become economic engine for any city that we go in. And the other project that we put together was building a global trade hub to facilitate the trade between the Far East, Latin America, and America, which is basically because I've been traveling through the world, through the Far East, and I've seen that importers, they have to fly for 24 hours to try to bring a container of goods or to make a deal, and then come back. Maybe they receive, maybe they don't receive it. So I figured if we build a global trade hub with many showrooms / offices that people can come and can create and can do business. And businesses, you know, when you meet physical business, create business, make bigger business. Ultimately, the vision is to make Miami as the Hong Kong of the Western Hemisphere. Until now, Miami was a tourist city, but it's changing and changing very fast. It's creating great opportunity. It is very diversified, great taxation, great weather. There is no 50 million coming through the ports, airports, 15 million visitors. So there's no reason that Miami would not serve will not serve as the gateway to Latin America as a capital. I know some people don't like the word capital, but a place to meet, we call it, slash. A place to meet, a place to work together, a place to collaborate. The philosophy that we're working under, it's the post-industrial revolution philosophy, and I call it the Mana 4C. It's collaboration, because the economy today is all about collaboration, unlike what it used to be 20 years ago, where it used to be competition, fierce competition. I kill you, or you kill me. If not, I buy you, I shut you down. It's all about collaboration. It's all about connection, connecting the dot, connecting the communities, connecting those who want to succeed, connecting the investors, connecting those who really want to use the product, communication, which is important, and compassion. Compassion is very important. So we connect with schools of the world, and we bring them into our ecosystems. We contribute for schools because schools is the foundation for everything. Education is the foundation for anybody to succeed. There is no such thing. You know, school is that's what separates us, human, from the animal. So we want to help those who really need to gain the knowledge, to give them the knowledge, help them, and support them. Our ecosystem also is geared towards memberships in terms of housing, in terms of working, apps connecting the community for purchasing. So this is like what I did. I took the industrial revolution and it impacted our life, because we used to live in communities, and the industrial revolution made us travel away from our homes, from our families, and be alone in our home. The car, we spent 300 hours, 400 hours, 500 hours. I figured if we build the housing next to the offices, it's going to save hundreds of hours. It's going to save a lot of money also. It's going to be also much more productive when you go out. And when you go in the morning, when you go in the evening, people know what you do, people support you, and people try to help each other. So Latin America today representing a huge opportunity, because it is overlooked, and now the young generation of Latin America, I travel in Latin America, and I see the need, and I see the urge, and I see how much they want to connect. And it's representing a great opportunity for many, many countries and people.
Thank you, Moishe. We said we're going to ask three questions, but he said let me go a little bit longer. So let me ask you a couple more, but quickly. Some of the vision, thank you for sharing the vision. And I think some of the people here in the room should know that this vision has been applied in some of the neighborhoods that you developed.
Yes.
Like Wynwood in Miami. And it's only going to Wynwood that you would realize that who's behind everything that Mr. Mana is saying has been coming through in this particular neighborhood. There's in the audience Latin Americans, there's Koreans, people from the Caribbean as well. But if you were to talk about what are the concrete opportunities for the Korean investors in this project in the Silicon Valley of Latin America?
Okay, in general, I think Korea is facing huge challenges. Korea is 50 million people, sitting next to 1.5 billion Chinese. And Korea traditionally used to be a manufacturer, but Korea cannot compete anymore on manufacturing. Korea need to outsmart the others. And the only way is through changing. I've been in Korea here, and I see the energy of the young generation. It's overwhelming. They all want to be part of something. They all want to do. They all want to create. So Korea must go into other areas, which is basically branding, innovation, trades, logistics, and so forth. And Latin America today, maybe some people be upset with me, I call it the invisible planet. It's 700 million people that we have over there, sitting on the last land reserve left post-industrial revolution. creating huge opportunities with a young generation that have apps, they have internet, that they're reaching out to the world and they want to change their lives. Korea must take part of the changes, the leading the change of Latin America. Korea can capitalize on the whole thing if Korea can take a step further. Korea is in good terms with the Americans, and I think the opportunity there that laying down for the Korean to reach out and invest in Latin America, it's huge. But what we are doing basically in Miami, I call it, when we coming and invest in Miami, and what we're doing, it's a diversified investment vehicle where you capitalize on the real estate, on the fashion, art, entertainment, and you capitalize on the content. Miami represents 1 billion people economy between Latin America and North America. I personally think that Latin America and North America economically will be on the same page sooner or later. So the opportunity is tremendous for the Korean people, and I've seen, and without insulting, you know, what I've seen in Korea, I've seen the Koreans tend to be very vertical and tend to invest very much in one thing, what they learned. You know, they go to the best schools, great education, but investing vertical, it's very dangerous. You got to be more diversified with your investment. We provide the diversity because our investment not only based on real estate, it's based on technology, agriculture, fashion, entertainment, and so forth. It's a much more healthy a vehicle.
Thank you, Moishe. The last question I'm going to ask you, and this is something that has come naturally for you. Lots of companies, and especially here in Korea, are talking more and more about sustainability. There's a much bigger effort in sustainability. We have seen here in Korea a change of the largest conglomerates into a more sustainable way of providing services and products. And this comes naturally for you. I just wanted to talk a little bit about your strong advocate for long-term mentality, and you know, how is that built into your business, sustainability and transparency?
Okay, this goes back a little bit to where I'm coming from and what my vision is and where it's coming. I came as immigrant to America. I grew with no money, and I wanted the opportunity to go ahead and change the life of my family, and later on, I've upgraded to change the life of others. We all as kids, we think we have dreams to make an impact in the world, to change the world. I got to realize I cannot change the world, but I can change the life of few people. And the investment that we are doing today, the kind of investment we are doing today, it is something, it's really groundbreaking that nobody has experienced. And I have issues because now we are on the road to raise money to get more people more familiar with this kind of investment, because people like to invest in boxes. What box I should put it in? I said there's no box. The box is you as landlord, you invest in the tenant, and you capitalize on the tenant talent, and his procurement. So the vision that I have here, I believe that we more and more we are going towards a global economy, a global world. The distance are shrinking, and this is part of a vision of making the world a better world. Closing the doors doesn't make your home safe. Throwing the garbage through the windows doesn't make your home clean. The world problems the problem in the world are global problems. Cyber is a big problem. Global warming, the ocean, the human engineering that we're facing, the new human that's going to take our place, replace us. These are global issues. So with our project, what we are trying to do is build communities that would be a healthy communities that will have the opportunity in the long term, and this project will go beyond my time. I totally believe that the Industrial Revolution created a lot of damages, a lot in the way we're looking at business and the way we're looking at investment and the way we live. We need to go back. The community was for us in the past. For thousands of years, we lived in communities, and the communities was good to us. We shared, we collaborated, we got our moral support from our community, and in a sense, we went to which community? The Facebook is a community, LinkedIn is a community, Amazon purchasing is a community. We don't have the physical. I believe in going back into physical communities. I think it's a much healthier way of living, and it's a much healthier, it provides more possibilities for the individual to succeed. It's not communism, each one will succeed, each one, you know, is a capitalist by himself, but he is part of something. People want to be part of something. So this vision, I believe, is going to be adapted in the world, and it's going to be beyond my time. This I'm convinced.
Thank you, Moishe. Thank you for your strong views and this amazing story, and good luck with this project. Please, a round of applause to Mr. Mana.
Thank you. Thank you very much for both of you for such an engaging fireside chat. Thank you very much once again. Now, you may return to your seats, gentlemen. Thank you. Now, again, without any break, we're going to go right into the second plenary session. And this session is titled Korea and Lock, an Agenda for Prosperity Through Trade and Investment. And for this session, we have a moderator, and the moderator and six other panelists. So I would like to invite them onto the stage before I introduce to them. So the moderator for the second session and the panelists, could you please join me here on the stage?